Hey, what's up, ladies? It's the relationship guru, Sid Farrell. Now, I'm back again with another video just to give you ladies. Now, before I get into this video, please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so that you're notified every single time I post. And if you are a woman that needs relationship advice or want to learn more about how to think like a man or why men do the things they do, act the way they act, and think the way they think, then I encourage you to book a one-on-one session with me. Link is in the description below, and I can help you out personally one-on-one with any questions, concerns, or anything you have regarding your dating life or relationship currently in general. And also, go pick up my brand new girls night card game. Is officially out. So if you're having a game night with your homegirls and you need something to do, then make sure you go pick up my girls night card game. It got a lot of fun questions and scenarios about love and relationships and all in between. It's fun for you and all your friends, so make sure you go pick that up. The link is in the description below. And also on this hand, we got my brand new ebook. It's called Oh He's Toxic Period. And if you never want to be played, used, or manipulated by men ever again, then make sure you go pick up that ebook because it's fire. Link is in description as well. All right, and I know I did something a little different today, y'all. You know, I hope you enjoy this shirt, you know, a little different from the bow tie scene, but that's besides the point. We're gonna jump right into this video, right? And this video is titled Why Are Men So Emotionally Unavailable, right? So why is it so hard for a man to express his feelings, express emotion, be compassionate, be sympathetic, empathetic, or why he doesn't properly and thoroughly communicate his feelings with you? Like, why are men so emotionally unavailable, right? Okay, ladies, so I'm gonna just give you a few reasons why men are so emotionally unavailable and why they don't express their feelings to you. Why aren't most men really in tune with their feelings, and why don't they just express themselves, and why aren't they just fully comfortable with just communicating and expressing their feelings? Like, what's wrong with that? Okay, so ladies, I'm gonna just explain it like this. So when you're a man, right, we're going to run it back. Let's go all the way back to when that man is born, when he's a little boy, right? When he's a little boy, and let's say he's a toddler. Let's say he's 2 years old. When a two-year-old toddler boy falls and scrapes his knee, he starts crying. What did the parents say? Oh, stop crying. Stop crying. You'll be all right. Stop crying. You'll be all right. Man, you know, we gonna rinse that off, and, you know, we gonna get you a Band-Aid, and we gonna get you some Neosporin, and you gonna be all right. You know, you gonna be good. You know, we gonna wash it off, and you gonna be okay. You know, walk it off. You good. Walk it off. You know, they tell you walk it off. You good, right? Okay, that little boy, he grows up. Let's say he's now a teenager. He's playing football now. Let's say he plays football, he gets knocked out too hard. You know, somebody tackles him, you know, he on the floor, you know, let's say he messed his leg up real bad. He might have just broke his leg. You know, maybe he's really injured, he's really in pain, he cannot get up. What his coach say? Man, get up, man, go walk it off, man, you be all right. We're gonna wrap you up with some ice and you're gonna be good. You good. So that man never got a chance to even express how he felt. He never even got a chance to express, hey, coach, this hurts. When he was a little boy, he never got a chance to express, hey, mom, I'm really hurt. You know, I scraped my knee and this really hurts, you know? You just told him, no, stop by that crying. You a boy, you a man. Get up, get up, get up. You know, you told him that, and now that's how he thinks, like, oh, that's how it's supposed to be, right? So now he didn't even have a chance to even express himself. He didn't even have a chance to even express, oh, I'm hurt. I'm hurting right now. He had no chance but to, because you showed him, you told him that he's a man and he should just walk it off, because that's how men are supposed to be, right? Same thing with his coach. His coach told him, oh, you're supposed to just walk it off. You good? You all right? We're going to wrap you with some ice, and you're going to be right back out there on that field. But hold on, I'm really hurt, though. It don't matter. Go back on the field. You a man. You know, suck it up. Suck it up. Walk it off. You a man. Ain't no time for crying. You a man. And you shouldn't be crying. Ain't no, you a man, right? So that man never got a chance to express himself. So when that same man grow up and now he's an adult, right? He's an adult now. Now it's like in the real world, men are still not able to cry because society, and maybe not you as a woman, you may say, me as a woman, I'm not going to look at a man any differently if he cries. You might not, but how men know and how men are conditioned is that society views you as weak. So that man is like, if I express my feelings, my emotion, how I am and how I'm feeling, I'm considered weak, because my whole life I'm considered weak. And my whole life I haven't even been able to fully express myself, because nobody even wants to hear me out when I am being expressive. Because every time I cry, or every time I'm in pain, or every time something happened, my whole life, somebody told me, hey, walk it off. You a man. Walk it off. You good. You good. So I never even got the chance to even know how to properly and effectively learn how to communicate my feelings and express my emotions with anyone or any type of way, because I was never even accepted or even heard out. And nobody ever heard me out to even hear my cries. They just told me walk it off. So I don't even know how to even express that. So that's one reason why a lot of men are emotionally unavailable, because it's that grow up timeline, is that when that man grows up and he's a man now, all his life it was like suck it up, walk it off, you know, forget your feelings, forget how you feel. You a man, it don't matter, who cares? You know, you gotta suck it up and you gotta keep moving, right? So that man is looking like, well, I don't even know where to even start to express myself, because I can't even express myself, because as soon as I express myself, people call me weak, or people say, suck it up, walk it off, you good. So what am I supposed to do, right? So when that man gets into a relationship with a woman, right, it may be hard for that man to express himself to you, because he's going to be like, okay, I cannot seem weak, because if I express myself, I'm going to be deemed as weak, or maybe I don't even know how to express myself, because I was never even accepted to even tell anyone, because nobody cared, right? So now when I come to you, I don't even want to say nothing. I'm emotionally unavailable. I can't give you my feelings. I can't share certain secrets with you. I can't be vulnerable with you. I can't let my guard down. I always got this guard up. I can't let it down because I'm a man and I gotta stand on that, because my whole life I've been conditioned that way. So ladies, a lot of times it's not a man's fault, right? A lot of women, they look at a man and they're like, why are you so emotionally unavailable? Do you just not care about me? Do you just, what's wrong with you? Like, and you think something's wrong with him, but a lot of times it's been that way. He's been conditioned that way over time. Every time and time again, since he was a little boy, it was always, you good, you a man, walk it off, you good, stop all that crying. What you crying for? I'm not even able to even cry. From a baby age, I was told I can never cry, I can never show emotion. I gotta be macho man, I gotta have my chest out, and I gotta look like, you know, I'm unfazed by the world and nothing bothers me, and I just gotta just handle everything and just walk it off. That's all I know, is walk it off in straight face, and I just gotta deal with it. And that's a lot of times it's bad for us men, because a lot of times a lot of men, they keep so much stuff bottled up, and the whole world be on our shoulders, and it's like we got the world and everything just bottled up inside us, and we're never able to really get it out and express it. And sometimes the man expresses it in the wrong ways, because a lot of men that don't know how to express themselves or express how they feel, they take it out on in different ways. That's why a lot of men, you know, they put their hands on women, or they disrespect women this kind of way, or they do this or they do that, or they act out different ways. They do illegal stuff, or they do, you know, different types of crimes and stuff like that, and they act out, or, you know, they lash out or do different things because they're not able to express themselves. So they never knew how to effectively express themselves. So they express themselves in negative ways to just get that type of energy or that type of feeling out, you know, in some type of weird way. That's why, you know, little kids, you know, they'll throw temper tantrums a lot of times, because sometimes it's something deeper that person is going through that they're just trying to get out, and they just want to be heard. And it don't matter how they're being heard, whether it's positive or negative, they just want to be heard. So they're going to cause some type of noise, and it doesn't matter if you perceive it as positive or negative, they just want a reaction because nobody hears them, or they just need to lash out, or they just need something just to get that energy out, you know. So not saying that is right, but I'm just saying that's the logic behind it, of the buildup and the reasoning behind it, right? So that's the reason why a lot of men, you know, act out or lash out or emotionally unavailable, or just shut down completely. A lot of men shut down completely. Some men, they show their emotions different ways, in negative different ways and stuff like that, in other ways that are not effective, that are not positive. But other men, you know, they're emotionally unavailable when they shut all the way down, and they don't want to talk to nobody, they don't express their feelings, they don't tell nobody nothing, because they know that if I tell somebody how I'm feeling, they're going to look at me as weak. Even if they tell me, oh no, I know, I'm not going to look at you like you're weak, I'm not going to feel like you're weak, they know that deep down inside, society, not you as a woman, not you, but society deems men as weak because if you express your feelings, or you cry, or you show any type of emotion, it's like, you a man, suck it up, nobody cares, move on. Nobody cares. You a man, suck it up, move on. You know? Now, when it comes to a woman, you know, let's go to the same scenario. Let's backtrack. Let's go to the same scenario. When a woman is a little girl, and she's a toddler, when she falls and she cries, what does the parents do? The parents go, oh, it's okay, baby. They pick her right on up. They pick her up quick. Baby, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. You're going to be all right. You're going to be all right. You good. You good. You good. They holding her. They kissing on her. It's okay, baby. Stop crying. It's okay. You know, it's okay. So you rubbing on her. But with that little boy, you told him, hey, suck it up. You good. You know, he start crying. Stop all that crying. Stop all that crying. You doing all that crying. Stop all that crying. You a boy. You a man. Stop all that crying. You know, get up. Get up. Get up. You know, you telling him that. But then when it's a little girl, you're holding her. You're securing her. You're allowing her to express her feelings. And that's another reason why women are naturally conditioned, you know, even though it's in their nature, but they're even more conditioned to show their emotions because it's more accepted in society than it is with a man. So that's the reason why a lot of men are not accepted, because, you know, even from a young age, you're conditioned not to show no emotions. You're conditioned to not express yourself. You're conditioned that nobody cares. Suck it up, you a man. So that's how a lot of men think, and that's how a lot of men are. So ladies, you know, when you look at a man and you say, oh, you know, a lot of men are emotionally unavailable. I don't know why all these men are emotionally unavailable. Why are men so emotionally unavailable? He don't care. He don't show his feelings. He don't tell me what's wrong with him. You know, I'm trying to let him know. I'm trying to let him know that I'm here for him. And he can be vulnerable with me. And I want him to tear this wall down. I want him to communicate with me. I want him to be open and honest with me about how he feels. I want him to just communicate and just be open, right? And he don't do that. A lot of times it's because it's not his fault, ladies. It's because it's how he just grew up. It's just how society raised him, how his parents raised him, how just the world just conditioned him to be. So that, because men are just, let's be real, a lot of men are just not allowed to cry. And you might say, Sydney, yes, they are. They are allowed to cry. We don't judge them. But society, may not you individually, but how society does it, you know? And it's just the truth, you know? So that's just what it is. So going back, ladies, you know, a lot of times it's not always the man's fault that he's emotionally unavailable, right? A lot of times it's just how he was raised and just the conditions around him. So don't just blame the man all the time. It's not always his fault. You know, a lot of men, you know, it takes them a little while to open up because, you know, it's been a habit in their life for so long that now they got to break that habit. And now they have to be vulnerable with you. They have to learn how to be vulnerable with a woman and to kind of let their guard down and to show that, you know, I'm not weak for telling you how I feel, you know, but you got to make him comfortable to be like that. And if you don't make him comfortable for him to trust you like that, then he's never going to open up to you, right? So you got to make it, you got to be his safe place and you got to make him open, and you have to know, you have to really make him comfortable with you so that he knows that it's okay and you're a safe place and you're not going to throw it back in his face. Because a lot of men, they don't want the woman to throw it back in their face like, oh, you remember that one time you cried? Yeah, you soft. Yeah, you weak. You don't never throw nothing back in that man's face if he came to you and he came to you like very vulnerable, because that might have been very hard for that man to do. So don't never, like, if you ever get mad at him, don't never throw that back in his face. Like, oh, remember that one time you cried to me? Remember that one time where this happened and you was upset and he was really going through it? Like, don't never do that. Don't never do him like that, you know, because it might have been very hard for him to even come out and say that. So, you know. So just allow him to just express himself. Just allow him to just, and when he's ready, don't rush no man to just be, you can't just expect no man to just, okay, now that I'm comfortable with you, I just gotta just tell you all my feelings. Some men are just not in touch with their feelings like that. And you just gotta understand that. Some men just naturally are just not in touch with their feelings like that, you know? So you just gotta understand that. And sometimes he just don't wanna talk. Some men, a lot of men, we deal with things differently than women do, right? So you just gotta understand that. You know, we may not express our feelings, you know, the way how you express your feelings, you know? You know, our feelings, you know, we might keep it just bottled up, we might just, you know, not trip over it or whatever, you know, stuff like that. You know, we just deal with it differently. So just allow him to deal with it. And he'll come to you whenever he feels like he's ready to. Don't rush him. Don't pressure him. Whenever he feels like he's ready to open up to you, then allow him to, right? But just don't emasculate him when he does, right? Don't make him feel like he's less of a man when he does open up to you, okay? Just be open and just allow him to just express himself and don't judge him, and everything will be good. You know, if you want him to be emotionally available, but give him some time though, because a lot of times it's hard, right? So ladies, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification, and I'm out of here. So to the next video.